So welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at creating a dynamic form with PHP on our Raspberry Pi server. So we're running Nginx on our Raspberry Pi server, and we're going to create a temperature conversion form. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. You can follow me at The Urban Penguin, and on Facebook, you're able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So far, we've created an Nginx website using the Raspberry Pi and installing Nginx. And then we looked at creating HTML pages with CSS. And in the last video, we added in then PHP, and we were looking at a dynamic page with PHP info. But that might not be what you think of as a dynamic page, and you might want to be able to gather and work with user input. So that's what we're looking at today, creating a very basic form to calculate temperatures entered in degrees centigrade and then display them converted in Fahrenheit. So we are looking at the website currently through the Midori browser, but you'll see later that we'll move on to another machine because the Midori browser doesn't handle forms too well. We'll be working with our IDE Genie, so the same thing that we've been working with so far, and we're looking at our info page, and then we can then just go through and save this as and create a new page. And making sure it's in our document root, so var www, so that's where our Nginx website is pointing through to. And we'll just call it something simple like c.php. We can worry about naming standards and how we name our files a little bit later. But the key is that it's a PHP file, and it's in the var www directory or wherever your document root is. We can change the title to whatever we feel suits, and the header, the h1 tag, we can then go through and again change that to something more appropriate. And then in our menu, this is where we have our link, so we can then go through and copy and paste a line down and then just adjust it so it matches properly with the new page that we want to put in. So we can tidy up some things we didn't do before, so we can call then the info link info, and we can call the temp link temp. Of course, that's going to now the /c.php, so the root of the web server, and of course we can put something like temp. Now we then go down to our content area. We're going to keep the PHP tags because we're still going to be using some PHP, and we're going to start off with PHP, but we can get rid of the PHP info. We don't need that anymore. We're going to put the PHP first, and then after our PHP, we're going to have HTML form, but the HTML form doesn't need to be part of our PHP tags. We remember that we define any PHP code within our HTML document with the PHP tags. So we're going to start off by looking to see if information has been submitted. So we're going to create then a simple if statement with PHP, and we're going to look to see if information has been set, so if information has been submitted. So we use then the function isSet. The if statement itself has the round parentheses, but isSet being a function needs the parentheses to enclose what we're testing. And we're going to test to see if the submit variable is set in the system superglobal underscore post. So we go through and read. To read from the post array, we use square brackets, and we enclose then the element that we're searching for. So we're searching for the submit variable within the $_post_array. We need to close the parentheses for the isSet and close it for the if statement. So we then, after the submit, we close the square brackets and two closing brackets there for the isSet and if condition. We're now setting up our brace brackets, and our brace brackets define the block of code that will be run if the condition is true. And essentially, we want to be running the calculation. So first of all, we read into a variable called $c. We read in the submitted value. So we're going to create a field on our form called temp. And we're reading that in then to a variable here that we're calling $c. So again, we go through to our post array. This is information that has been submitted. We read in then the element temp. This must match the field name in the same way as the submit element we referenced earlier must match the submit button name. So same as before, we have those in square brackets. And at the end of the line, we then just have our semicolon to indicate the end of a PHP line. When we go through and look at $f, this is going to be our calculation. And in here, we're going to use round brackets to control the order of evaluation. You might have heard of BODMAS, so brackets, exponents, division, multiplication, addition, and then subtraction. We want to make sure that certain things happen in the right order. So first of all, we must do multiplication and then division. So we're going to put those elements within round brackets because the brackets are evaluated first. So I'm going to put a couple of brackets first, opening brackets. We're then going to have our $c, our centigrade temperature, and we're going to multiply that by 9, once I get that right, let's just go back. So it's then multiplied by 9 and then divided by 5. And then you can see that's where I had the two opening brackets, but they're now closed off. The next is to plus 32, but that's going to, yeah, addition happens towards the end anyway, so I'm not so worried about that. But it was important to make sure the multiplication happened before the division. And again, a semicolon at the end of the line will make sure that that's ended properly. And now, of course, we need to display the information back to our users. So we can just use echo. Remember, we're still all within our PHP block. So we can echo and then open up our quotes. So these are double quotes. The double quotes will allow our variables to be expanded. So we want to show something like the $c is $f. So we can show something like then $c, c is $f, f. We could leave it like that, but if we wanted to put in additional tags just to make sure that it's emboldened properly, then we can put in our normal HTML tags so they will be interpreted. And then we can go through and put our closing tag. So that's the condition that we're looking for and the code block that we're going to run if the condition is true. We don't need to worry with an else statement. We're going to be showing the form in any case, and this is going to allow us to easily do multiple calculations. So we can get straight into then our standard HTML tags here. So outside of our PHP tag now, we're creating our form element. So form and then method equals and in quotes post. So this is just describing how we submit it. We can see that we're reading from the post array. This is making sure that we send to the post array. The action equals defines which PHP script we're writing to. So with this, again, we can use a little bit of PHP to make sure that we write back to this PHP script. So we can use then PHP underscore self. So we open up a new PHP tag. And then we echo out the contents of our server array or underscore server. and we read in the element php underscore self in uppercase. We can close that off. So that's written as before with square brackets and the element that we want to read in single quotes. We end the line of code and then we end the PHP tag. So we can write this on a single line, but of course we still need the semicolon to tell PHP that that's an end of line. We can then go through and end our quotes for our action and then end our HTML tag for the form method. So we've opened up a form now. We can start describing elements within that form, the fields that we are going to use. So with this then we're going to use input type, and we can have this equal a text field. So we can then have just type equals text, not test. We can set up its name value, and the name value is important. It must match the name value that we're reading from within our PHP script. So name equals temp. The name that we set here must be the name that we're reading from our post array within the script. It doesn't matter about the quote being double quotes or single quotes, but the actual text value must be the same. So with this set up, we can then just have a new line. So we just put in the break tag. And now we go through and create a new element on the form, the submit button. So in the same way, this must match the submit button name that we chose. So we can have input type. And this time we're going to set it to submit. So it's a button. So type equals submit. And then the name equals submit. And again, it's the name part here that must match. Of course, the type equals submit is saying that it's a button, so that must be correct. But the name must also match what we're reading from within our PHP script. And then don't forget to close that. We're also going to put a value on here. The value then is just the data that is shown back to the user. So we'll have the text word convert shown on the button, put our break, and then end our form element. So this is now pretty much done, but we should just run a watchful eye over it to make sure it matches more or less what we think that it should match. So as we're reading through, we can go through to our PHP script. So checking the post values, looking through here where we're populating our C variable, there's actually a bit of a stray round bracket. So just removing then a round bracket from our $C line. We can check then the variable $F and our calculations, and our brackets all look fairly good for that. And then just sort of simple echoing information out. So we're only running that piece of code if we have submitted information, but of course it all needs to be correct for it to be interpreted okay. So then looking at our second set of PHP and our form, that all looks okay, but just looking here, it should be values equaled. I've missed out the equal sign. So with this then we can go through and save it, but I say we'll have a look within our Firefox browser running on a different host. I've also copied across the link information through to the other pages so we'll be able to navigate between all three pages. So we just fire up Firefox on my Ubuntu host, and I'm pointing through now to the IP address of my Raspberry Pi. And we can see now the c.php page is showing correctly. I can navigate if I want to through the different pages. We're on the temp page. But if we then enter some information and submit it, we should then get to see the conversion. So 100 degrees C is rightly enough 212 Fahrenheit. But if we then go through and put something like, let's say, 20 degrees, then that's a nice comfortable 68 Fahrenheit. So our calculations seem to be working nicely the way they should. And we've created a dynamic form that we're viewing from another host within Firefox. So hopefully this gives you an idea of some of the things that we can use our Raspberry Pi for. But don't forget, this isn't just Raspberry Pi. It just makes a simple process using the Raspberry Pi and simple, cheap computing. But we're looking at creating our dynamic forms with either Apache or Nginx in this case, and PHP. So hopefully you found this useful and you'll come back to theurbanpenguin.com very soon.